See, this is superiorly ilium, anteriorly pubis, and posteriorly ischium. Okay, then. Now, when you just see, this is anterior superior iliac spine, and this is the pubic tubercle. Okay, these two should be in same plane when you hold the bone. This is anterior superior iliac spine. This is pubic tubercle. When you hold the bone, you should hold in such a way like pubis bone should be front, okay? Ischium bone should be behind, back. Ilium bone should be above. Acetabulum should be facing outwards because head of the femur will come and fix here. So this is outside, the dorsal surface, okay? That's how you identify the bone, whether it is right hip bone or left hip bone. Okay, beta? Yes?
Ma'am, I could not hear you in between, ma'am.
Anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle should lie in the same plane.
Okay.
Okay. Then, after that, what did I say is, when you hold the bone in anatomical position, pubis bone should come in front.
Mm-hmm.
Ischium bone should go behind.
Okay.
Ilium should be superiorly. Then acetabulum should be outwards, out. Mm-hmm. What is fixing here in the acetabulum? Head of the femur.
Femur.
Okay, what joint is formed here? Hip joint.
Hip joint.
Yes, okay. So that's how this is the place where we have the head of the femur. This is the, that means acetabulum should be facing outwards. That means the anatomical. So which hip bone is this? The one which you are seeing here. This is the right hip bone, which is shown on this slide. Okay, pubis, ischium, and ilium. Okay, acetabulum facing outwards. Okay, now see. I told you when you hold the bone, this is the anterior superior iliac spine and this is the pubic tubercle, and when two hip bones are meeting, this is the point where two pubic bones will fuse. This point is actually called as pubic symphysis. Okay, so they should lie in the same plane, same coronal plane when you hold the bone. Okay, then you need not worry with small, small details. Don't worry much. I'll show you everything and discuss.
Ma'am, can you repeat that point? Something you said, same coronal plane.
Anterior superior. Anterior superior iliac spine and pubic symphysis should lie in the same coronal plane. Ritika.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, but so you need not worry about the other details. Anyhow, I will discuss with the help of diagrams. Okay. Now see here. This is ilium. So this surface is facing inwards or outwards? Just look at the diagram and tell me. Inside.
Outward.
Outwards was acetabulum, no beta?
Okay.
Outwards will be when acetabulum is not there, you tell if it is wrong also. Others will also get a clarification. Okay, this is inwards, beta. This is like pelvic surface, this is. Because the right and left hip bones all will join to form the hip, like pelvic cavity, no? That's right. So this is all pelvic surface. The other surface where we have acetabulum is dorsal surface. Okay? Now, we are talking exclusively about ilium now. Ilium. So in the ilium, see, this is upper expanded plate. Okay? So it has two ends. What are those? It has upper end, then it has lower end. See, this is upper end is this, and lower end is this better. Okay, upper end and lower end. Then it has three borders. What are those? See, three borders. So this is anterior border. Okay, moving from anterior superior iliac spine to anterior inferior iliac spine. Okay, so which border is this? Anterior border. Okay, this border which is behind is posterior border. Okay, moving from this is anterior superior iliac spine, this is anterior inferior iliac spine, and this is the anterior border. Okay, behind is posterior superior iliac spine, posterior inferior iliac spine, this is posterior border, and here in the pelvic surface, one more border will be there, which is called as intermediate border or the medial border. Am I audible, Ritika?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, this is anterior border, this is posterior border, and this is the medial border. Okay. Then the surface, the one which you see from outside, where we have acetabulum, this surface is gluteal surface because it gives attachment to gluteal muscles. The other surface towards the pelvic cavity is pelvic surface. Okay, beta? Got it? Pelvic surface, gluteal surface. So in this surface, you are finding one fossa-like area which is called as iliac fossa, depression. This is iliac fossa. And this area is actually sacrum bone is articulating here to form sacroiliac joint. That's why this area is sacral area and this area is the pelvic area. Together you call it as sacropelvic surface. So how many surfaces we have? Three. Okay. So what is this surface from outside?
Dorsal.
Dorsal or
gluteal?
Gluteal.
Gluteal.
So this surface is actually iliac fossa. So nice. Very good picture this is. Okay. And then this is sacropelvic surface. Sacrum bone and the pelvic cavity, you will see sacropelvic surface. This is the intermediate or the medial border, beta. This one,
ma'am. This is right hip bone or left hip bone, ma'am?
This is right hip bone, beta. This is like this, right hip bone, pakka. Okay, this is anterior superior iliac spine, anterior inferior iliac spine. This is iliac crest. Okay.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
This is posterior superior iliac spine, posterior inferior iliac spine. This is anterior border, this is posterior border, this is medial border. Okay, then this, are you finding again articular cartilage here? What may be this? Pubic symphysis.
Okay.
This area, that means right pubic bone and left pubic bone will come and articulate. That's the reason you have a hyaline cartilage there. Okay. That is here sacroiliac joint. That's why hyaline cartilage again. Okay. So some features are very beautiful here. That's why I'm using this picture. But this surface, is it outside surface or inside surface? Pelvic surface or dorsal surface? This is
inside.
Inside. Very good. Pelvic. Excellent, Ritika. Pelvic surface. Okay. Then now see here. See, this is upper expanded plate. So whatever I told you, it has superior, like this is the iliac crest, beta. Iliac crest. So you have seen anterior border, posterior border, intermediate or the medial border. We have seen iliac fossa, sacropelvic surface and the gluteal surface. So this upper expanded area is called as iliac crest, which is extending from anterior superior iliac spine. It is extending to posterior superior iliac spine. Okay. See this complete thing. Then, so iliac crest to show. See, if you, this is the anterior superior iliac spine, isn't it? So when you just move your hand behind 5 centimeters behind, you will find there will be a tubercle. Okay, there will be an elevation towards the outside, which is actually called as the iliac tubercle. Okay, 5 centimeters behind from the anterior superior iliac spine, you will see the iliac tubercle over the iliac crest. Okay, I'll use the diagrams, otherwise this becomes very confusing. So it becomes easy for you. So I'll use maximum diagrams. Okay, this diagram is good. So when you talk about, see, iliac crest. So iliac crest, this is the anterior superior iliac spine. Okay, that means here pubic bone is in front, beta. Okay, then, so this is posterior superior iliac spine. You are completely, what do you call this area is?
Crest, iliac crest.
Iliac crest. So iliac crest, no, it will have two lips. Like it has outer lip, it has inner lip, and then it has intermediate area. Okay. Understood? Outer lip, inner lip, and intermediate area. Then Now, when you move from behind, like 5 centimeters behind, I said, from anterior superior iliac spine, just go 5 centimeters behind, you will find one bony elevation. What is this?
Tubercle.
Tubercle.
Iliac tubercle.
Of the iliac tubercle and the tubercle of the iliac crest. Very good. Okay. Now, when you see from outside, what is outside? How to identify whether it is outside or inside part of the bone?
Acetabulum is outside.
Acetabulum. Okay, fine. Very good. So when you see from outside, okay, the external surface, it will show 3 gluteal lines on the ilium bone. Because this surface outside is gluteal surface, where we have gluteal muscles, isn't it? So we have 3 gluteal lines. What are those? See here, this is greater sciatic notch pattern, this area. Okay, what is this notch? Greater sciatic notch. So from the greater sciatic notch, if you observe, there is one line which is moving from the apex of the greater sciatic notch to anterior inferior iliac spine. What is the name of this gluteal line? This is below, niche. That's why you call it as inferior gluteal line. Okay? Okay. Then again, just little above, you will see there is one more gluteal line starting, which is moving almost up to the tubercle of the iliac crest. From the apex of the, what is this? I said greater sciatic notch. From the apex of the greater sciatic notch to the iliac tubercle, we are finding one more line. What is this gluteal line?
Anterior
gluteal line. Okay. Now when you see behind, back, peach, there is one more gluteal line again starting from the apex of the greater sciatic notch. Then it is going up to the outer lip of the iliac crest, outer lip. Again around 5 centimeters in front. Okay. So what is the name of this line we have? Posterior gluteal line. So overall, how many gluteal lines we have?
3.
Okay. So those are inferior gluteal line we have, then anterior gluteal line, and then posterior gluteal line. So between these gluteal lines...
Ma'am, can you repeat inferior gluteal line once again?
Yeah, beta. Apex of the greater sciatic notch. If you just consider this area as a triangle, greater sciatic notch, this becomes apex, beta. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
From here, if you draw one line extending from the apex to the anterior inferior iliac spine. Yes?
Okay.
You call it as inferior. Gluteal line. From again apex to iliac crest, you call it as anterior gluteal. Okay? From again little above from the apex to the outer lip, around 5 centimeters behind from the posterior superior iliac spine, then you call it as posterior gluteal line. So overall in the gluteal surface, how many gluteal lines we have?
3.
So what are those? Posterior, anterior, and inferior gluteal lines. So these gluteal lines are actually very well marked in case of males when you compare with females. Why they are so well marked in males? Because the muscles are much more used in men. Okay, so that's how you will see the all gluteal muscles are coming. Behind the posterior gluteal line, you will see gluteus maximus. Between the posterior, this small area only, but maximus beta. Remember, it has many more origins. That's why only this small area. Between the posterior and anterior, you have gluteus medius. Between the anterior and inferior, you have gluteus minimus. That means maximus, medius, minimus. These are the gluteal muscles which are arising between the gluteal lines. Okay, I'll show you with the help of diagram. See here, little. Now this was the posterior gluteal line, right? Behind the posterior gluteal line, what is the name here? Muscle name?
Gluteus maximus.
This is the posterior gluteal line, and this is the anterior gluteal line. Can you see the name of the muscle here, beta? What is this? Medius. Between the anterior and inferior, ye dono ke beech mein, what are you finding? Gluteus minimus. Is that clear? Because when you talk, see, if you are thorough with osteology, origin, insertion, nerve supply, action becomes easy. Always, that's the reason we start with osteology in limbs. For upper limb also, I gave you osteology knowledge first. Okay. Okay, beta. So now see, is it clear? What are the muscles coming between the gluteal lines? Then we will talk about iliac crest. Okay? I'll show you the attachments of iliac crest. Don't read theory, becomes difficult. Once you know the, see here, this is iliac crest, beta. Okay? Now you should know which is anterior end. We are taking only iliac crest picture here. Is it clear? Only iliac crest. You have taken the picture from above, superiorly. So this is anterior superior iliac spine. Okay, this is posterior superior iliac spine. Is that clear orientation?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh. Now see here. Now this is the anterior two-thirds. This is convex outwards. Yeh bahar ka hissa, outwards. Whereas posterior one is concave outwards. Okay? Reciprocally inside. Okay, then I told you iliac crest has outer lip, intermediate area and inner lip. Do you remember iliac crest has? Suppose this is the iliac crest. So it has outer lip, it has inner lip and in between you have intermediate area. Okay, so like that. So this becomes outer lip, this becomes inner lip and in between area is the intermediate area. Now this is anterior superior iliac spine. When we did abdomen, you remember IHS inguinal ligament?
Mm.
Extension is from where till where? From the anterior
superior iliac spine
to the pubic tubercle. To the pubic tubercle, isn't it? So that's the reason you are finding inguinal ligament attachment here. This is outer lip, right? And the outer lip, first muscle you are finding is tensor fascia lata origin. This is one of the muscles of gluteal region. We will study structures under the cover of gluteus maximus. You should remember all the names. Okay. Then you are finding the insertion of external oblique. We have seen external oblique was arising from the ribs, right? Linea alba, xiphoid process. All those words we came across when we were doing this muscle. So insertion part is there in the iliac crest. Origin of internal oblique is again like medial to the origin of external oblique. So medial lip or the inner lip, you are finding the origin of transversus abdominis. You are finding this is all in order, isn't it? First then outside to inside I am talking better. The anterior two-thirds segment, outermost is tensor fascia lata. All three origins, only one is insertion. Which is the insertion? Which muscle is inserted here? Blue one. Ritika? Hema? Are you able to hear me?
External oblique, yes ma'am.
Yeah, external oblique. Remaining all tensor fascia lata, internal oblique, transversus abdominis, they are taking their origins. Okay? Then. Now see, this is the anterior two-thirds and then this is posterior one-third. In the posterior one-third, like that means, what is the name of this projection? Posterior superior iliac spine. Okay, so there you are finding which ligament is attached between the sacrum and hip bone. You have the sacrotuberous ligament. Okay? Sacrotuberous. Okay, but then apart from that, if you observe, see, in the outer slope, you are finding the origin of gluteus maximus. Okay, then you are finding the rectus spinae muscle is also originating. I told you thoracolumbar fascia also very clearly. These green lines are actually indicating the attachments of the thoracolumbar fascia. So we have rectus spinae muscle. Okay, as you move little more anteriorly, we have quadratus lumborum. Outside is latissimus dorsi, inside is quadratus lumborum. Okay, then this outer lip is gluteus maximus and inner lip is erector spine. Okay, practice this diagram. It is given in all textbooks. Practice it for yourself so that you remember more. Okay, all muscle attachments you should know. For your osteology viva and also for your critical, any question comes, gluteus maximus may come, any of the muscle can come, okay? Attachments of iliac crest also may come, something like that. So I hope it is clear. So we have talked about two things, beta. We talked about the attachments of iliac crest. We have seen the gluteal surface, we talked about gluteal lines, right? Then we will try to speak about some more muscle attachments from the gluteal surface only. See here, this we have already done. Same thing actually. Okay, you are finding like, which is the anterior end here, which is the posterior end. See, this is the pubic bone, right? This is the ischium bone. So this is the anterior end. You have inguinal ligament here. So just now we have seen various muscles, tensor fascia lata, insertion of external oblique, latissimus dorsi, outside we had, isn't it? Then erector spinae, gluteus maximus. Like that you just correlate with this what we have. You are shown only the outside visible muscles. The other ones are not shown. Now, apart from that, from the anterior superior iliac spine, you are finding one more muscle. What is that muscle originating? Sartorius. Emma, am I audible?
Ma'am, it's breaking a bit, but you're audible now, ma'am. Okay. Now it's okay.
Anterior superior iliac spine, apart from inguinal ligament, we have sartorius. Okay. Anterior inferior iliac spine, we have rectus femoris butter. One is straight head, and above acetabulum, we have reflected head. Reflected head. Okay. Then these are the muscle attachments, what you see from outside. Okay. Then posterior inferior iliac spine, you are finding which muscle? Key muscle of gluteal region. This is called as piriformis. Piriformis. Okay. Now,
what is it called, ma'am?
Piriformis. Piriformis.
Key muscle. It's called key muscle. Huh?
Key muscle of gluteal region. I will discuss this again when I am doing gluteal region, because below piriformis, sciatic nerve comes.
Okay.
Sciatic nerve comes. This you will understand thoroughly when we do gluteal region. Okay. Just a term I'm introducing now. Okay. Now this is clear, beta? Outside muscle attachments. Now, what is this surface I told you? This surface is iliac fossa. And this is sacropelvic surface. Okay. So iliac fossa, very simple to remember. You have the muscle iliacus. And in the sacropelvic surface, you will have ligaments, which are connecting the hip bone to the sacrum bone, which are helping in the formation of sacroiliac joint. Okay, let us see the muscle attachments inside. Got some idea? No, see here. You are finding inside muscles, internal oblique, transversus abdominis. This is anterior end, this is anterior end, this is posterior end. This is pubic bone. Check for pubic symphysis always. It becomes easy. This is posterior is thick bone, ischial tuberosity. Okay, posterior superior iliac spine, posterior inferior iliac spine. Now see, what is the muscle I said in the iliac fossa? Very simple to remember. Iliacus. Iliacus. I told you here all ligaments. No? Sacroiliac ligament, which helps in the formation of the sacroiliac joint. A part of pelvic cavity. Okay, like that. So now coming to anterior superior iliac spine along with inguinal ligament, what is the other muscle we saw originating? Sartorius. Sartor means tailor. Tailor muscle it is. I'll tell you later again details. Below this you have anterior inferior iliac spine. Okay, here you have straight head and reflected head you will see from outside above acetabulum. That's why it's not shown here. Okay, beta? So these are the details which you should know for ileum. Okay. So that is, now let us just read what are the points given. Pubis and ischium I will discuss in next class. It's a very big, like, and moreover, two students also are not present. No. Okay. And moreover, only 3 minutes are left over for this Zoom to disconnect. So you see here, upper end is iliac crest. It is moving from anterior superior iliac spine to posterior superior iliac spine. Okay, I told you 5 centimeters behind we have the tubercle. Okay, this anterior two-third segment is the ventral segment. Okay, the attachments we have seen from outside to inside. We have fascia lata. Fascia lata is the deep fascia of the thigh, which we will study. Okay. Outside to tensor fascia lata, we will have the attachment of fascia lata. Okay. From outside to inside, we have fascia lata, tensor fascia lata, external oblique. Okay. When you come more like behind, you have the latissimus dorsi, then internal oblique, then transversus abdominis, quadratus lumborum. Okay. Apart from this, fascia transversalis and fascia iliaca. Where is fascia transversalis present? In abdomen, we have come across this, isn't it? Fascia iliaca will be covering iliacus muscle. Okay, so that is, this is anterior 2/3 is
peritoneum ke upar na ma'am.
Ha, peritoneum ke upar. Very good beta.
Upar ek fat ke upar transfer.
Ha, correct. Very good beta. ये पूरा एंटीरियर 2/3 जो है यू कॉल इट एज वेंट्रल सेगमेंट. यहाँ से यहाँ तक, फ्रॉम हियर टिल हियर यू कॉल इट एज वेंट्रल सेगमेंट. ओके, पोस्टीरियर 1/3 इज कॉल्ड एज डॉर्सल सेगमेंट बिकॉज इट इज बिहाइंड, पीछे. ओके, सो नाउ इट इज, आई टोल्ड यू लाइक इट इज डिवाइडेड बाय ए रिज इनटू आउटर रफ सरफेस एंड इनर रफ सरफेस. ओके, आउटर रफ सरफेस इज गिविंग ऑरिजिन टू विच मसल? Gluteus maximus. Inner surface, which muscle? Erector spinae. Erector spinae. Okay, whatever green line we are finding, that is nothing but the attachment of thoracolumbar fascia. Okay, you need not remember these nerves better. Anyhow, I will discuss these nerves when we are doing lumbar plexus. Okay. Then what else we have seen? This is the anterior border, right? Extending from the anterior superior iliac spine to anterior inferior iliac spine. Okay, what is attached to anterior superior iliac spine? Inguinal ligament and sartorius here. Okay, beta? Then. So you need not remember the nerves and all. Posterior border from where till where? Posterior superior iliac spine to posterior inferior iliac spine. Okay, so it gives attachment to sacrotuberous ligament. Here you can see sacrotuberous ligament.